Hi.
Hi.
Hi, everybody.
Hey there.
Hello, everyone.
Salam sejahtera.
各位，大家好。
Good evening, my fellow Singaporeans. My name is Chee Soon Juan, and I am the Secretary General of the Singapore Democratic Party.
I'm Dr. Paul Annan Tambaya.
My name is Benjamin Quinn.
I'm Min Cheong.
My name is Robin Low.
My name is James Gomez.
My name is Wayin.
I am Daman Huri Abbas.
I am Tan Jee Se.
I'm Alfred Tan.
Support me and support the SDP.
Please support us. Support SDP.
Support the SDP.
Support the SDP.
Support the SDP.
Sokong SDP.
உங்களுக்கு பணி செய்ய நான் காத்திருக்கிறேன்.
சி சி நோங்னாங், சி சி மின்புடாங்.
Support us to help build a democratic Singapore based on justice and equality.
I invite you, my fellow Singaporeans, to stand up and walk.
Hello, my fellow neighbors of Holland Bukit Timah and Bukit Panjang.Last year, the government attempted to commemorate the bicentennial of Raffles' decoration of Singapore for the British Empire. I want to talk about a more important celebration. I want to talk about our senior Singapore citizens' effort and contribution to the life and well-being of this nation. The latest statistics showed that compared to 30 years ago,There are now many more seniors, 65 years old and above, still working in Singapore, despite having worked a good 40 years before, and often I'm sure with much vigor and pride, our seniors still need to work. And many of them continue to work because they have to make ends meet. Life still has to go on, and bills still have to be paid.Early in their working lives, they were told to contribute towards their retirement funds. They were told to move away from their pension programs and instead to trust the government's Central Provident Fund, to trust that their CPF will be able to fund and look after them when they retire, for them to enjoy their golden years, to taste the sweet fruits of their labor. What a rude shock!To a number of our seniors when they found that their CPFs were not sufficient to sustain the life that living in Singapore requires. Living here in Singapore is expensive. So many of our seniors have resorted to moving out of Singapore, sell their homes, or to depend on monies from their children and relatives, so as to continue life in this city of gleaming towers and tall buildings.This sad situation has forced some of our seniors to take on menial and extremely low-paying jobs just to attempt to live and hopefully attempt to keep some dignity in their golden years. We see them cleaning tables, cleaning plates, guarding buildings, collecting cardboards and waste. What kind of honor as a successful, proud,And amongst the richest country of the world, can we say about being a society that is graceful and humane? I say that this shameful state of affairs has gone on for too long. What kind of government do we have that closes a blind eye to the sad plight of our seniors? What kind of government do we have that demands our seniors to beg for help? Our seniors have dignity.They deserve our appreciation and respect. The government has no heart. The SDP proposed our RISE program, where the bottom 80% of seniors be provided a $500 monthly cash automatically. This $2.8 billion program can easily be funded from our budget. Just prioritize and scrutinize the operating and capital budgets more prudently.And I can assure you that we have enough based on the present sources of funds. Recent research suggested that a minimum of $1,380 is required to live adequately in our golden years here. Another survey indicated that retiree households living in public flats have been receiving about $500 from their children and relatives. This national gesture of $500 will also help our economy as our seniors put this back into it, as they buy their food and groceries, attend to their healthcare needs, or ride on our transport system. If we, as a gracious and honorable society, can set aside and provide this $500 to our seniors, we can also lighten the financial strain on their children, who must also be working extremely hard to take care and feed their own families. The world after this COVID will be difficult, and we must extend our help whenever we can, especially those who are weaker and disadvantaged amongst us. We are a community that need each other to support each other, all so that we can survive and grow as a stronger society together. Let's not say we cannot afford this. Let's instead say that we can prioritize this. Voters of Holland Bukit Timah and Bukit Panjang, let's agree to show honor and respect to the seniors who had worked hard and contributed to the foundations of this country, and upon which we all have also benefited today and become stronger. I ask you to vote and put the SDP team of Ms. Min Chong, Dr. James Gomez, Mr. Tan Ji Se, Professor Paul Tambaya, and I, Alfred Tan, into Parliament. Let us speak up and represent you. Let us be that compassionate and respectful conscience in Parliament. Vote SDP for 4 yes, 1 no.